Then an intense blue would superimpose on top of that, then purple, but it'd stay layered, you know? Like I could see these shadows, auras. And then the air in the room got real thick. Like they were these invisible strings floating around, you know? But I would breathe them in, but not all the way, so that my chest couldn't relax, you know? My throat widened. And the crickets, they got louder and louder, almost like a constant screech, you know? So I got out of my bed, went to the window, opened it up. That's how I knew I was awake. Because the next morning, that window was still open. And in the backyard were 50 to 100 of these little Jiminy crickets jumping around. But they weren't real, though, you know? I mean, they were definitely cartoons. They had on top hats, you know, with long auburn hair that flipped up at the end, you know, like Marlo Thomas hair. And after a while, they all started dancing around. The biggest cricket, he just sat there staring at me, you know, like he was contemplating whether or not I understood what the dance was about. And then he let out this high-pitched screech, you know, like a cat being run over. And all the other crickets stopped dancing. And he started coming towards me, pushing the weeds out of his way. He went right up to my window, and I was scared, shitless. And he slowly took off his top hat. And he spit this big blue unit. And he looked at me and he said,
"Wow! Son of a freak is out there again!
Oh shit!
South end of the stage!
Oh no!
Have one hand!
Where's Mona?
No show!
Sonny, you gotta take your next set, man!
Right.
Hey, I've done the same thing. Now I gotta go out there with that psychopath meditating on all my moves.
Being fucking deal. It's no worse than those businessmen looking at my butthole like it's a picture from Mars.
Who is this guy? Donna, are you gonna do it or what?
Oh. What are you doing out there? I lost it for you an hour ago, remember?
Donna? Yes, I will do it.
Well, someone, please tell me who this guy is.
I don't think we should tell her.
No, she's too young.
Yeah.
Wow, she's been fuck you.
Yeah. roommate last week. I was just hanging out with her till the bus came in. She started wigging out on me.
A transsexual?
Yeah. She has breasts, but she still has, you know.
I know, man. Red says each operation costs a shitload.
It takes more than one operation.
Yeah, I guess.
They do it one testicle at a time, Jane.
There's a lot of shit involved, you know. She has to see her psychologist, make sure she's adjusting to each thing and stage, you know.
Which is not happening. She's totally obsessed with dying.
Hey, that's all her, man.
What is her name?
She had some weird fucking name like Luna.
Oh, shut up, right?
That is a pretty name.
Lucia wants to be my art in progress.
Fucking weird. Sounds like something you would say.
Fuck you.
The only difference is Donna's in control of her life.
She got a fan of the gangbang bush.
What is she gonna do?
I don't know. You know, maybe she is one of those transsexuals that are in the strip joints. Right, Jean?
If I were you, I wouldn't get tips from the sound man.
Yeah, lose that on 30 bucks.
What is the problem? I thought you liked those kind of people.
Those kind of people?
You know, like me.
I like anyone who's got the balls to be unique.
Yeah, maybe you hang out a lot on Pulse.
So what, man? Lucia freaks me out because she's psychic.
Oh, God,
what? You're trying to send me messages, okay?
And you are so weird.
Oh, and you are so normal.
I don't want to hear that satanic stuff.
It's not satanic, man. It's just spirituality, you know? Like energy transmitting to energy.
Like the radio.
Exactly.
My feet joke about it.
Yeah. Hey, Lucia comes out in my dreams. She comes out in my mom's dreams, too.
I'm not in my dreams, Anna. You gotta get on stage.
No, I don't.
Yes, you do.
Oh, you'll love this one. Starts with me in a room full of dancing penises. And this half serpent, half politician comes out of this toilet in the center of the room and he made you, the man, he has toilet paper. So bad, I have to say. Deja vu.
I like her dreams. They're creative.
Oh, God. That psycho, she is gonna get me.
Here, just do a line. Stay to the north end and stare at the wall.
Just do a line. Stay up the wall.
Shit, man.
I gotta stop doing this shit. No fucks with my singing voice.
Stop, man. Come on, move your ass. We're losing guys to Big Al's.
Oh, are you sure it's just not your dancing?
No, what have you got there?
Hey, a lot of mucus.
Yeah. Not a lot of brains.
Sounds like Lacey made shit for a tent.
Ladies and tweakers. We here at Madame Lem's Pig Barn proud to present the anorexic delight, the queen of dumbass dancing, and the only stripper with mucus for brains, Lada Bane.
We all have it. I mean, I didn't know about your sister until right after the divorce. When I tried dating, you were about 5. Danielle, she was 8 or 9. You were asleep when I got home, but Danielle, she was up. And she was a night owl even then. She wanted to know about my date in excruciating detail, of course. So I sat on the edge of the bed. I started to tell her a little bit about him, hoping I could avoid listing all the colors that one could find in his iris. And then this strange thing occurred. Danielle, she jumped in. She took over the conversation. She started telling me what he looked like, where we went. She saw us in a restaurant. She was dreaming about us. She said that she didn't like the way his hair and his eyebrows when we talked. I mean, I told her it was just a bad fitting toupee. I didn't want her to have nightmares about aggressive scouts from hell for the next entire week. It was a real special night. It was the night I realized that we had a connection, all three of us, that we were partners for a lifetime. What the hell do I know, babe? I just know we seem to exchange more information on the psychic level than we do over a telephone. Especially since Danielle's moved to San Francisco. I can usually turn it off.
Oh man, Bear!
I can't right now.
Bear!
The weirdest shit just happened to me.
Not when I sense her in danger.
Bear, where the fuck are you? I am taking the longest shit in my life, hey mom!
Yeah.
What is it?
What are you scared of?
Hijo de la gran puta.
Jesus, I thought I never was gonna eat it.
I know that feeling.
Well, it didn't actually, I just gave up. I'll go back later for the second showing. The package of big news that ate my toilet, part two. What?
Man, Bear, sometimes, you know, I just slip out something else.
That's real specific. One espresso, about a fresh shipment in it, so.
I'm sitting at the Al Monkey Cafe, alright?
You're probably better than that.
I'm working on this painting.
Wait a minute. I thought you were going to get a job hunting today.
Oh, I needed to take a break.
But honey, you promised me you wouldn't take any more
breaks. I know, but it's just been hard to find a cool job, you know?
No, but rent's less than a week away.
Well, I'll get one tomorrow. I'm considering topless dancing.
Oh, God, there'll be
it. I'm serious.
Of course you are. So, what was today's weird event?
Well, I'm sitting at the Al Mikey Cafe, right? I'm thinking that I'm not getting surreal enough with my painting, you know? And so I tap on my insecurity attacks and I say to myself, you know, you haven't got the eye anymore. And this guy sitting at the next table says, and the lady he's sitting next to says, your bad eye distorts your good eye. Look, getting chills all over again.
Did you tell him to fuck off?
That's what freaked me out.
Go with you.
I turn to them, and they act like they're not saying anything.
No figure.
So I decide I'm just going to watch them for a while, you know, catch them in the act again. And while he is talking to her about some bullshit psychology work, this blue neon stream of light comes out of his mouth and moves over to her head and wraps around it, you know, kind of caressing it. And she speaks, and this red neon stream of light comes out of her mouth and moves over to his neck and slides up to his face and his eyes. And it was really rhythmic, you know, kind of sensual. So I look away, you know, and try to snap out of it. And I see this guy arguing. You know, the cashier.
Yeah.
And they've got these brown and gray streaks coming out of their mouths, you know, but it's really violent, like and I'm thinking, whoa. I gotta get the fuck out of here. So I just peeked at my things, you know, and I left.
Well, it can all happen to you, Danielle.
A lot of it.
You see, you change your name to something that odd things will happen.
I know, the whole thing was a total deja vu.
You are the only roommate I've ever had who has more than three deja vus in a day.
It's only been this heavy since I tripped with Rob and broke his car. There's some. Could it have been a flashback?
From one acid drip?
Well, you can get herpes from one kiss. Oh, whoa. Not another deja vu. You cut that crap out. I'm gonna get jealous.
No.
Well, that's sweet.
I just remember another time that I saw those
trees. I didn't express it. Keep talking.
My dad took us to the Barnum and Bailey Circus once when we were kids, you know? This is during the year that Dustin and I lived with him.
Dustin?
Yeah, my brother.
Oh, yeah, the Little Republican.
No. He's getting weirder as he gets older.
Runs in the family, I see.
Yeah.
So you're at the circus?
Yeah. And these two girls, man, they just kept staring at me. No. My dad made me wear a dress. I hate dresses, man. I think it is bullshit that women have to wear them, you know? I mean, they are so constricting. Sure, you can squat and take an easy piss, but try running for that end judo when you're late for work.
You're derailed, Danielle! Zaya!
I know, but it's true, you know?
Yes, yes. Give me easy urination any day, so you're at the service.
Yeah. And I'm thinking how I'm looking at this fucking flower dress, you know? And these two girls, you know, they start making comments about what I'm thinking. So I turn to them, and they act like they're not saying anything, same thing, you know. And that's when the streams or whatever started coming out of their mouths. Really freaky shit.
Well, are you sure they didn't have too much cotton candy and weren't just throwing up?
Strings? That is so weird.
What?
Did you just hear that?
What?
Man, I've been hearing stuff lately.
Oh, come on.
No, I'm serious, you know?
Well, as long as it's not a voice telling me to kill me, I don't worry about it.
Well, it's not that good yet. I'm just kidding.
Shit.
No, it's like whenever I hear something funny or weird, you know, I hear this laugh track in my head, like from The Love Boat or some shitty show like that.
I figured it out. It's a flashback to a satanic episode of Father Knows Best.
Oh, God.
It's coming.
Figures. Live 1 year in middle-class suburbia, and I am psychically scarred for life.
Please turn that crap down. Look, Bernie, why don't you put on that Captain and Tennille album, you know, the one that your grandma gave you for Christmas. You can just skip over that Muskrat song. I know you don't like it.
I hate living here.
I don't want it though.
How normal.
What exactly is this? You know, when you're Annie Joyce and I, when we were kids, well, we used to have these nice embroidered sayings on the walls of our room.
Mom says she's getting a lawyer on Monday.
Have you ever heard said, little girls are made of sugar and spice and everything nice?
She's got a nice apartment.
And mine said,
getting us back would be easy.
Little boys are made of snakes and snails and puppy dog tails.
It's just going to take a little while.
Now, I know that you probably think that's square, but...
Dustin.
That is the way it should be, not the other way around.
I promise we'll stick up for each other until then.
I know if my dad had heard your Andy Joyce play that Alice Cooper record, he'd have burned it in the fireplace. Then he'd have drowned there for a week. You're lucky I'm as tolerant as I am, Danielle. Danielle, this is your father now. You don't ignore me. Honey? Fine. Pretend you're Howard Hughes, lock yourself in your room all summer long. You'll be sorry when school starts and you haven't made friends around the neighborhood. They'll think you're a loner.
Deal?
Kind of kids pick on.
Deal.
You start high school and start dating boys.
Okay.
Then you act like that Alice freak.
They're just a creep.
They'll just think you're weird.
And you are so weird.
Okay. I do wish you were genuine too. I lost it too.
Chris? No.
How many times?
Oh, I've only done it once.
Right, Patty? And I shaved my armpits.
Oh, you're such a hippie.
There are no such things as hippies anymore. I'm just hip.
All right. I told you. Now it's your turn.
Well, yours was no big surprise, you know, because everybody in school knows about you.
Chicken out!
I am not chickening out!
Come on! Who'd you secrete your liquids with?
You don't know him.
It doesn't matter!
Yes, it does!
I'm under no.
Okay. Here goes. I will come back from the dead to seal up your vagina forever.
Gross. You are so gross.
What? I think vagina is a beautiful word. It sounds like a tall Asian princess. Gross. I'm so gross. I bet you thought I wasn't too here.
Gee, what are you not blasting my pot?
Oh, blasting my pot!
I shouldn't have smoked it alone!
I meant to smoke it alone!
Okay,
don't you make dogs
twice!
Twice
in my mind!
Okay.
Thank you.
There's this big pool full of this deep blue water, and and Rob was there swimming in the nude.
Oh, that's why you brought him up.
I always wondered what it would be like to be with Rob. Then you took off your gloves, jumped in, and started swimming towards him, and I just like started laughing, you know? And then you threw me this really bitchy Barbie doll look. You know, like with your eyes. And I said, fuck it. I took off my gloves and jumped in too. And started swimming towards you guys, and after a while the water started turning red, you know, but we just kept swimming. And the whole pool turned to blood. And the blood got really thick, you know, like it was gonna scab over us. And that's when you said, I'm having a deja vu. Then you put on this black and white dress and cap, cape, suit, you know, like ballerina penguin dress. Like a, God. Yeah! Like a lion! Dude, I just woke up. You want to paint your dreams. What are you talking about?
I do.
Not mine. You saw the last painting. The last painting you did was of Alice Cooper in new eye makeup. Okay, what about my Las Vegas dancer?
Oh. Is that the one with the three boobs and those bloody spikes coming out of her thigh?
Yeah.
Oh man, that was a dream.
Yeah.
Oh, that is more like something out of Creature Features.
I love the dead before they're cool.
The blooming Jasma, mighty moon.
I just don't remember.
Never was upon me see.
Penny, you're
going
to
get
the
shit out of your mouth!
You know, when you're peasants, they live life and see all because of written their lives.
I don't know what I'm going to do. My mom wants me to get a bachelor's degree.
Ooh. Before.
I don't know. She says it would have been better for her, you know, if she would have had one after her divorce.
Gosh, you're a freak, huh?
No. She just thinks that, you know, that Hopkins Street wouldn't happen if we would have had a direction or something.
Hopkins Street?
Yeah, that's the house that's the one I lived in when we were kids. She just thinks that, you know, that like that weirdness wouldn't have happened.
What are you talking about?
Nothing. I just think that my mom hated being a bartender.
Oh, whoa! Why? Oh man, I would love that! That would be so cool! You get all the free drinks you want. You know, and then you can like throw a party for your friends.
Yeah, man, your best friends.
Hey, let's do something.
What?
How would you like to see Rob tonight? You went to the Strand in SF to see Rocky Horror.
Yeah. How do you get from San Jose to SF?
Drive.
With who? Red?
No, many of ourselves.
Now we haven't got a car.
I know we don't have a car, but there are plenty of cars parked up a Stevens Creek.
Bullshit!
Easy, we just drove Red to his car out of town.
You've been seeing him since it was like a spell.
Yeah, man, he's a bitching guy.
Jesus!
This is the first shift. What if we get pulled over? All we have is your permit.
If we get pulled over, it won't matter.
What if we get caught?
Fuck it! God damn it!
Oh, fuck!
No! Fuck it!
Unbelievable!
sister out of jail. She and Patty were caught trying to steal a Volkswagen. They were pushing it down the hill and it hit a police car. Don't you get any ideas? If you ever try to steal anything or risk your safety, I will put you through that goddamn wall. Do you understand? There are going to be some changes around here. I'm going to let Danielle take the proficiency test and she can move out and live in the dorms and enroll at San Francisco State. And there she can, no visuals, it was only sound. But I knew that there was a little girl inside a small room. And the room that had no windows, and all the doors were locked from the inside. But I knew that she had her ear at the keyboard. And I was really, don't rely on your truth. Your bad eye distorts your good one. It's not easy letting her go. You know, every situation has a myriad of reactions to choose from. I can't always know which one is the best. She's never been on her own before. I've never had a 17-year-old daughter. The first for everyone.
I decided to continue sending your sister child support after she turns 18.
All I can do is remember how it was for me at that age.
Well, nothing. She's a female living on her own.
Remember the mistakes I made.
It's different for a man.
Better from doing the same.
Danielle needs help surviving.
Get a direction.
She's very impressionable, just like your mother was.
She needs to get an education to sustain her.
I don't want her to go through what your mother did.
No one should be as powerless as I was at 27.
I am not saying that she's going to crack up or have an emotional breakdown or whatever it was. I'm saying that she's very impressionable and she can be easily influenced by some of the scumbags that live in the city. And I believe that if anybody is going to influence my daughter, it should be her family. Do you understand me? The city is a very dangerous place for a woman. In fact, the only women that should live in a city are ugly ones with guns.
My dad?
Are bold guys.
My dad's on his third wife.
It's a joke.
Mine's on his fifth. And they're split.
Yeah. Is that it? Yeah, now you're a stripper?
I don't know. You don't talk to him? Do you talk to your dad, Lacey?
That's different.
My dad's an asshole.
Aw, you know hers isn't.
Did her dad finger fuck her when she was 10?
No.
Maybe wear dresses and play with dolls.
That bastard. Leon! Make the jarheads pay off or give up their seats!
God, what shit
happened? I warned you, a lot of fresh meat marines.
Hey, is Alicia still out there?
Yeah.
And she's cheap.
This sucks.
Hey, what was Red doing introducing me to that transsexual for anyway? It's not this kind of people.
It's just a deal, you know?
Yeah, but you know, that was pretty nice of you to wait until we're back.
You're stupid. Hey, I thought she was kind of entertaining, you know. I mean, she had this whole image that she perfected. I thought she was fascinating. Ah! Jesus.
Come on, what are you doing that for? Rick doesn't even do it as much as you.
Hey, man. We all have our little vices. I hate pop, you smoke it like a cigarette.
Hey, it's a scientific fact that cigarettes are worse for you.
I think it makes
the night stone.
I was at a friend.
And he had the TV on, and I just sat there for like 4 hours staring at that box. Even the commercials. That is sick. So glad I don't have any rights.
Says the little nymphomaniac to the druggies.
That isn't a vice. That's a gift.
Oh, the gift that keeps on giving.
Thank you.
Oh, is that it? Shit, what do you think that makes you funnier or dance better?
I see. It doesn't make me do anything.
It allows me to make myself a better dancer. Big fucking difference.
Real big, yeah.
Hey, I get more creative and bizarre, you know? I can work all night on a painting, you know? Not have anything wild come out of it. Some drugs, man, that can suck out hidden, even primitive creativity.
Bullshit.
You suck.
Hey, when are you gonna stop talking and start doing?
What? You're always talking about creating this or painting that at the time. The rest of the time you just bitch about how you never do it.
I get busy.
Yeah. Well, I think a real artist will find the time. Don't you?
I've got acid.
Oh, good for you.
Is it this chick I met in Santa Cruz? Oh, when we dropped, we were strangers, but man. After 8 hours, we were like soul sisters.
Another lesbian conquest.
Fuck off, Lacey. You know, I know a lot of girls who are just friends. Just because I'm a lesbian doesn't mean I'm a slut.
Excuse me. Okay, sorry. God, I'm going to be a bitch.
You guys don't want to play, I'll just wait for Jamie.
God, how many times have you done it?
Acid, I mean. Just once. You know when?
Right before I left SF State.
What did you do?
Friend from high school, Rob.
He's just waiting for me to get off the phone with my brother, you know, and I was drawing on my futon, and I just kind of gradually worked my way down to the hardwood floor. And it didn't hit me, you know, but he said that we should drop acid down because I could draw that design any place that I focused my mind.
That's cool.
I mean, I know it's definitely me.
Yeah, at one point it was really intense, you know, we were in the park on the stand-in side. And I was staring at the streetlight, you know, because it was pulsating, just like this one from Hopkins Street, from my childhood. While I was staring at it, the scorpion's tail appeared in the center, just like in this dream my mom had, you know, and it started to spin. And these wisps of light gently stretched out from its center and swirled around, you know, until they went past me. But I never took my eyes off that tail. And then the wisps froze. And this blinding light started to bleed through. It was like these wisps were making these cracks in my vision, you know? This light kept trying to force its way through. And I kept thinking, shatter! Come on! Shatter! I think I was about to leave my body.
God, that'd be wild, wouldn't it? Just say, fuck it to everyone, man. Turn a somersault into the void and never come back.
God,
yes.
I hope you do.
Hey, Shada. That's
not oh, shit. Red.
Oh, shit. Bones.
Hey, I'll make up for it on Wednesday, you know, because I get paid then.
Well, if I can't give you the sandwich they gave, if you're going to smell more than the shit, man.
I know.
Then why are you doing it?
I got a lot of shit going on right now, man.
Yeah, well, who doesn't, huh? Look, I'm trying to keep the machine moving, pleasing major players here. I don't need my dealers fucking me out of connections,
hey,
all right?
I need to fuck you up, Red, all right? Look, man, I'm back off, you know? I dance 5 fucking nights a week, man, you know? I take a lot of shit from sweaty pigs jacking off, okay?
I got a student loan, man, I can't fucking pay for. You know, my best friend, she turned into a fucking Jesus freak, man. You know, damn me to hell. And I got Lucia following me around, okay, like some psycho spy. Things are just, you know, man, things are just a little, I don't know, you know, like, chaotic for me right now, okay?
Hey, it's cool, man, it's cool, all right? Would you just relax? I mean, you are really amping right now.
It's just really cold out here, okay?
Well, Bones, I just thought you'd have the money you needed by now, that's all.
I know, me too.
Well, don't you pay a lot of cash for that?
25 a set, you know? Plus tips, but that's just it, man. They don't give me enough good sets, you know? And it makes it even worse when Lucia's hanging out, you know? She's been trying to send me messages, you know? I get these really intense and warped sexual images, you know, when she's around.
She's still strung out?
I don't know, you know, she's just, I mean, yes, you know. She's just, I don't know.
Zara, you're just too weird for her, that's all. I mean, you shouldn't have called her a biological wonder.
I didn't do shit to her, okay?
That's cool, man, that's cool.
You know, it's really fucked up, Red, you know, it's not even paint anymore. I mean, I just waste my time dancing or taking the bus, you know. I get home so late, I just crash to like 2 or 3.
In the afternoon?
Yeah.
Sleep too much.
It's hard to wake up, though, you know, because my dreams are so vivid.
No, Salt Bones. You're like my little sister, you know that?
Don't scam me right now.
Hey, I ain't trying to scam you. Look, I just don't like seeing you like this.
Hey,
that's
maybe,
a,
you know, I can't take
fine.
It right
no,
now.
Bones,
so
I'm not. Look, I'm just thinking maybe I'm going to let Bob do the run to San Jose.
You said I could do that run, right?
I know I did, but...
Man, you fucking said I could have that run!
Hey, come on,
man.
You really like doing this new one.
It's cool, you know? I mean, shit, I only deal with friends, you know? Okay, the only strangers that I score for were through you, bitch.
Look, I'm just thinking maybe you don't like doing this stuff. Maybe
it's
too easy.
It's cool.
You know, maybe you're more of a people person, you know? You're more of a more human contact.
Oh, Red.
You do know what I'm saying, though, don't you?
You are unbelievable,
you need the
man.
You excitement of a new experience.
What?
That's what it
you're
is,
you're pimping
huh?
Now, too, Zed, huh?
What's a twisted mind like yours doing a normal thing like that, huh? Look, this is different. I'm just bringing together happy people with other happy people so they can all be more happy. You understand, huh?
But this isn't me, Ben.
Look, I'm just spreading a little love here. Trying to make a lot of sexy girls like you and a lot of pretty boys like Rob a lot of hard cash.
But I just want to do the run, okay?
Well, it's going to take you twice as long to pay me back.
I know.
Besides, it's just like dancing. I'm making more money for less work.
Red, I'm not going to do it, okay?
Come on, you're going to miss out on all ladies' loving thing.
Red?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
No, this is your fucking choice, you know that? You fucked up, I can't use you again. And you still owe me.
Fuck!
If you weren't Patty's best friend. Hey, tell you what. Why don't you just fuck with Rob? Alright? Take me the only out of way you make this where everybody will be cool and you won't fuck up and you should be with Rob. I mean, he does have good street smarts for our pride.
Yeah? You got nice B.O. for an asshole.
Ooh, good one. The old Rocky Horror allies never die.
Hey, stop that, Red, man. I hate when you talk like my dad, you know? I hate fucking prejudiced
right.
Attitudes like
you're
that,
right.
Man.
You're right.
I mean, shit, why can't people just let people do and be whatever they want?
I don't know. Maybe there's just not enough loving, huh? Thank you.
Deja vu. Hey, don't, man. Wait a minute.
William, hey, I ain't your ex-boyfriend. It's cool. It's cool.
Hey, Red's a cop, man, okay? Red?
Why?
Because, no. Shit, cut it out!
Fine, Bones, fine! You go ahead and have boy in your own little world, alright? You just remember to have the money you owe me by Sunday. Hey, sorry. You either put in more nights dancing, or you think about my offer.
By Sunday.
Fine, just don't fuck up!
Happy! Sugar! I forgot my beans. I need an espresso. I'll look through your half of the cupboards. You don't have a thing.
I know.
Why?
I forget to shop.
Why?
I forget to eat.
My God. A metabolism like yours is the work of Satan.
Oh, screw it.
Well, I'm here. So, his name is William. Well, I'm glad I'm here. You're all gaga over the phone about this guy. I close my store early, forget my beans, rush home so I can have a much-needed vicarious romance through you, and you're lost in a painting of a... What the hell is that?
It's Van Gogh's ear. And these loose veins right here are going to sprawl out into the dark, wet streets of meth.
Ooh, how horrific.
Well, I mean, a severed ear sprouting a happy town like Yonkers doesn't seem to fit.
True. Don't you have any tea bags in your room, maybe?
You're right. It is horrific.
It's like a... Yeah?
Don't you ever wish that you had a nightmare, you know, instead of a regular dream, you know, just with the excitement and the adventure of it?
Yeah. I wish I could say yes so I could be as interesting as you, but I'm afraid I just stick with the occasional bad dream. This special interest group boycotts all the beans to save the ozone, and I have to close my store for a month. Real silly shit.
That's not silly. When you had that dream, it had an effect on you, right? An emotional effect?
Shit, yes.
That's why I'm doing this painting.
I'm sorry, I don't get the connection between espresso beans and a bloody beer.
Okay, I'm at my dad's house for Christmas, right? I'm seeing all my relatives, you know, and I'm thinking...
Wait a minute, now I've got to shift gears here. This is the normal side of the family, right?
Yes.
The side that likes to pass food clockwise around the dinner table?
Right.
Got it, got it.
So I'm sitting there at the dinner table, and after a while, you know, they all start asking me about school, and I just decide that I am going to drop the bullshit there and just tell them the truth.
You told them you quit.
Yeah, I told them I dropped out 2 months ago.
They must have shit.
They did. I know my dad did, because he got real quiet because I was chewing on the corner of his lip. That's what his tooth is. And then everyone just started coming down on me, man. My aunt, you know, she starts relating to me how she knows lots of artists, you know, but they all have an education. And you can't be a truly good one without it. And I'm thinking, fuck, you know, what is art anyway, you know?
Well, I think art is
not my dad says it's about being practical, but that's like death, you know? I think it's cool if you want to get close to your art for your lifestyle, you know? Now, you're a fucking textbook, man. I mean, there's no exact way you're supposed to go about doing art, you know? I mean, I could be a waiter, you know, or an accountant, some normal type job like that, and still create art. It's in the way you go about it, you know? I mean, if I reach for truth and perfection, you know, like style and whatever it is I'm doing, then there's an art form being created. A whole fucking existence is art, you know, unfolding and evolving. We are complex living creatures on some beautiful blue planet, you know, spinning around in an infinite universe. We are art.
I agree. And if I didn't know any better, I'd say you were on speed.
No, I'm not. What the fuck is that supposed to mean?
Hey, I'm not gonna judge you. Last place you need to build a fence is in your own home.
Okay, I ran into an old friend from high school. Red, you know, and he just got back to the city yesterday, you know, so we were BSing and he gave me a couple lines of crystal for the road, but that's all.
This isn't the guy you were gaga over, is
no,
it?
No, no.
That was Bill.
Yeah.
Is he a drug dealer?
No, no. William is a really cool artist.
Good. Bird the feather. Where's the meeting?
At the Owl Monkey Cafe. Thanks.
It's screaming.
Yeah. It's the lady at the end of the hill.
Oh, pretty fucking wild.
you dropped it?
Yeah.
It's drowning.
Yeah. You're on sarcasm. it's a lady at the end.
Whoa!
Yeah.
You did that a lot?
Yeah. See it and then put it down on paper. Yeah. If I don't see it, I just make it up. My name's William.
Oh, I'm a Daniel. Saw that.
How long have you been drawing dandies on?
Oh. No, it's just lava. I've been drawing, sketching, you know, painting, whatever, since I was probably about 10.
You're good.
Thanks. You have nice bone structure.
Oh, that's because I haven't broken any yet. Okay, anyway, see some of
them?
Do you make
your
living off these?
No, I'm living off the student loan.
You should set up on Telegraph in Berkeley. Yeah, you could definitely sell these.
Well, I'm not ready for that.
Why?
Because this is just surface stuff, you know? I mean, I haven't even really tapped into the good shit in my life yet.
You're scared.
No. I just think there's a lot more that I could do, you know? I mean, I would love to get into film, video, you know, combine all the art forms into, like, some really mind-blowing shit.
I'm just talking about selling your art, that's all.
I know.
Hey, just take me for face value, okay? There's not all the weird energy.
You got it.
What's this one called?
Neutrons, you know, vibrating at a really high speed. If nothing existed,
there's still the energy, you know, because you can't destroy energy. So, if energy is God, and God is love, then Patty believes you should be able to love everything around you, you know? I mean, objects, even tables, you know? I mean, not just, I mean, sexually, it's a little more pure than that, but...
Definitely. It's a cool picture.
She was a cool person.
Did you make love with her?
Yeah.
I did too. Who's my best friend?
Oh.
About a year ago.
I'm not a lesbian.
Oh, who cares, man? I don't care if you like to make love at tables, man. It's your business. I don't need some label to understand you better. Man, I hate labels. Except artists. Yeah, you're definitely an artist.
Oh God, he is so beautiful. I can talk to him about anything. I mean, anything. Okay, like one night after we had sex, he thought I farted. But I didn't, you know, it's just one of those vaginal farts. And he'd never heard one before, so he wanted to know all about it. What does it feel like to have air up in there and so on? So, of course, me, I'm just like babbling on and on about it. I think you really like him. God, he's so open-minded, you know? I mean, he just accepts me for what I am. Even if I don't know exactly what it is that I am. He's an artist. He sells his paintings on Telegraph in Berkeley. I mean, he wants me to bring some of mine down there to sell with him, you know, but I'm not going to because, you know, I mean, I just don't have the right paintings to sell right now. Oh, hey! I got a new job, but you gotta promise not to tell Mom, okay, or I'll kick your fucking ass. I started as a dancer at Madame Blum's. It's all I semi-knew, you know? Which actually helps me be more creative with my dancing, you know? I mean, I get totally into the theatrics of it. Nobody else there does, you know? That has gotta be why I make good tips. I mean, I give them the unexpected by having a little self-respect, a little humor. I mean, totally into it.
Do you really think that this is helping? I hope you realize that it only takes one wacko to follow you home some night and rape you. And there are a lot of wackos in San Francisco. Danielle, are you listening to me? Look, I know that I haven't been the best communicator, but you haven't made it easy. Not with these ideas that you come up with, these thoughts right out of left field. And it doesn't help that you have the same sense of humor your mother had. You have any idea what it's like to have your ex-wife speaking to you, to your daughter, in the same county, filled twice? But I am doing the best that I can, and it's not easy for me to I want you to know that, man, that I have accepted the fact that you're not, that you're probably not going to get married in the near future. That was a big step for me. But if you could just get something going in your life, Danielle, you're an intelligent young lady. Danielle?
Oh, hey! Get this. I call myself Zada Vane. Isn't that cool? I've been using it for the last couple of months. I say it, man, I just like click into this creative unconscious flow. I am telling you, man, I'm the best fucking dancer. You are lying to yourself. What is with you, man? I thought it'd be cool seeing you again after 3 years, but your mind so fucking close.
My mind is more open now than ever before, Danielle.
Zada.
Danielle. That is the name your mother gave you. But parading your body around a bar full of men is so degrading and wrong. You could do so much more with your life.
How do you know what I should do with my life?
Because I know Jesus Christ. Oh, okay, all right. I know it sounds hokey, all right? But saving your soul isn't. I mean, before Jesus, all I did was just follow the Grateful Dead or the country. I was doing a shit. I was doing nothing with my life. I mean, don't get me wrong, okay? I still love Jared. I met Jacob and his wife, and they totally understood. And they were so accepting of me, of everyone. And they could be because they had accepted Jesus Christ in their heart. All they asked me to do was to share their happiness. I mean, is that goal or what?
Hey, Patty, if you find found your direction or something,
no,
that's cool,
no,
you know, but...
No, it's not just my direction. It's the world's. I'm talking rapture, Danielle. I mean, it is totally mind-boggling. Something that can actually save your soul from this long ago. And the day I let Jesus Christ into my heart is the day that I saw all the sin that I was committing. All the sin that both of you committed. And I finally had a purpose. I've given my life up to Jesus' control.
This is so surreal.
God is the best guy, Danielle.
Yeah. So what, I'm supposed to ask JC for a hit?
Asking is the first step.
This isn't me, okay?
Look, I just want what's best for your soul.
Yeah, well, take a fucking number, man.
Okay, all right, okay. Sorry, okay, I'm not gonna push. I just came to say my piece, and I'm moving to Colorado, that's all.
Colorado?
I really try not to sin anymore, and I don't want to be around people who are sinners. So it's really enough. You were my best friend. I'll always be your best friend. But since the moment it's near, I have to speak with my heart.
What are you talking about?
Listen to me, okay? We are over 21, okay? We're adults. Would you please stop your dancing and your drugs and come with me? There's still time to remain.
Or
the end. Armageddon is all around us, okay? My guy has foreseen it. It's very complicated.
Did your guy give you a date? Are we talking like maybe or something?
Oh, would you please not shut me out right now, okay? I'm scared enough as it is.
Yeah, but is it because of what they're telling you or because of what you don't know?
It's because... I don't know, it's really hard to explain. Listen, I want you to hang on with this. All the answers are in there.
staring at a game board.
You just don't see it, do you?
It's shaped like a mandala.
You're too lost in this image of being an artist.
I am an artist!
Scorpion's tail in the center.
Oh yeah, well then I guess you might as well just start painting hell then.
I hear a voice.
Because without any control, that's where you're gonna end up.
It asks me if I want to see more about my daughter. I tell it no. The scorpion's tail begins to spin anyway. Pretty soon, the board breaks up and flies past me, and I see you. Just your face. Your eyes darting around wildly. There's a woman standing behind you. She's very ill, and she wears heavy makeup to cover it up. She begins to stroke your hair. Each stroke becomes more and more abusive, and your eyes, they start darting around faster and faster, and you reach up like you're going to reach for something.
He jumped us more than once?
Yeah. Does it make sense?
No.
Are you sure? She's in love with you.
I don't know why you dreamt it, Mom, okay?
Danielle, I usually don't pick up on these kind of images unless something is generating them.
I know.
Are you still doing drugs?
No!
Danielle!
What? Why won't anyone believe me, you know? I mean, these psychic binges or whatever, they're real, okay? Hearing other people's voices, seeing those emotional streams, they really happen to be, okay?
I'm not discrediting your experiences.
Yeah. And how come every time I come by to see you, I feel like I've done something wrong?
Because I don't understand why you want to put yourself in harm's way.
I am not doing anything!
Listen to what you're saying.
I am.
Who seeks out who, huh? You know. Been doing this ever since you were a kid. Do you remember after I went back custody of kids and moved to San Jose? There was a period of time that we all saw bright colors move. Remember that?
Yeah. We were really excited because we all saw the exact same.
And do you remember what you started to do in your room that night?
Me?
Yeah. You started attracting the brainwaves. And you did it by painting an ugly image of one of your nightmares.
They come whether or not I'm painting.
What do you mean they come?
I mean, I still see them.
You do?
Yeah, I see them a lot, you know, especially when I'm tired, you know, and I have that, like, fading feeling.
Did it ever occur to you that those dark ones, those gray ones, they give you that feeling? Okay. There's an exercise I want you to do when they come. Right?
Right?
I'm serious. I want you to take off all your metal jewelry. And I want you to imagine yourself inside a protective shell with walls of energy between you and them. I want you to think of something positive, a word or a name or something that you can keep repeating over and over in your mind, all right? And then I want you to turn on the radio or the television. Electrical energy helps to send them away.
I don't want to send them away, Mom. I kind of like that.
Okay, Danielle, this is not a game. Do you want to live through another Hawkins Street? If you keep yourself open to everything that is out there, pretty soon you're going to pick up on all the negative crap that is out there.
It's just exploring a feeling.
God damn it! I know that you are attracted to all the dark images in your mind, all right? It's part of human nature. But you need your center, you need yourself to contrast your perception of those dark images. If you give that away, you become those things. You have no more control over your art. Being your art, it's self-indulgent. To bring other people closer to it. To sense it, to maybe even see themselves in it. That has a purpose.
being the dream master, not just the dream.
But I have to at least get close to those images that inspire
me. Okay, Danielle.
What the hell is she?
Time to stop
being cool, she'll be here.
You need to reconsider taking classes and we'll be back on the campus.
Yeah, like I need to be out on Main Street all night. I don't want to paint fucking fruit bowls, Mom.
Okay, the environment will help get a direction.
She just lived 2 blocks upstairs.
Please. There are people I don't want to run into. This is my life, Mom.
Check it out.
I'm in control now.
Hey, Bulge!
That's her.
Yeah, but everybody else calls her Zaz.
Oh, that's it. Let's get everybody in on our drug deal. I'm rich. I'm rich. I'm not falling in love.
She's not been running.
I'm not going to be a bad girl. So I'm burning holes in you.
Bones, this is Lucia.
It's a pleasure to meet you.
Well, it's a biological wonder to meet you!
You got balls, don't you?
Yeah, you want to know why you can have mine.
Who are you and where is my candy?
I am inside of me.
I know that.
You're talking
about your act. Hey,
Beth!
Yeah, what act is that?
Wait right there! Hey, listen, ladies, I got some business to attend to, so I'll see you Friday outside the old monkey cafe.
What, you psychic?
No, just don't forget appointments.
Fuck you.
Ooh, please. No, hey, Beth, wait up.
Hey, I think I've seen you before.
Oh, you get the fuck off this street. Can you give me a ride to the phone?
Nope.
Oh, I guess I'm just too unique for you.
No, I just don't have a car.
Yeah. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm gonna take a walk down the pan.
Okay.
Thanks for the inspiration.
Sure.
Hey, you want me to walk with you now? Because
yeah.
Okay.
Go. God, I hate this street.
What's the matter? Don't you like all the skinheads that come out after dark?
No, I got a rule. Don't get yourself killed by somebody with a lower IQ than yourself.
Yeah.
I got that same rule about people I sleep with.
Yeah.
I think you bet your match.
What?
Come on, hold on.
Ah. Whoa, God, yeah, that burns.
No pain, no gain.
Yeah, I love it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You have got nice bone structure.
Oh.
What about my smell?
Patchouli.
Yeah,
I love patchouli. Thank you.
Mixed with your sweat.
Sorry.
No, man, I don't like it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I like you.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I know you. You work in Madeline.
Yeah, that's right. Did you see my set?
Yeah, twice.
Twice?
Mm-hmm.
What'd you think?
Oh.
Well.
Come on! It was mystical.
Mystical?
Oh, that is so cool, you know, because I try to leave my set open to
God, yeah, attention. You know that show?
Yeah?
Yeah, most girls, they just flash their twats in your face, jiggle their asses. You use artistry.
God! I'm an artist!
No.
No.
You are art.
I am art.
Look, if I'm in a box, all by myself, nobody's watching, and I'm molding wet clay, whatever.
I'm dirty.
Some of them love to play games, but you gotta play mine.
Oh, okay.
I'm the artist.
So?
So?
Come on, I describe it to you, you get a picture in your mind, right?
Yeah, but it's my own visual interpretation of that picture.
Yeah, your personal art, that is art.
Little girl.
I become your art. When you dance for me, you become my art because I interpret you.
Are you?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You too. I mean, your whole image and everything.
Yeah.
You like?
Yeah. What?
Steve.
No.
Lie.
Hey, calm down.
Yeah.
For what?
What?
Don't make me fight for this.
Hey, don't be so wigged out.
No.
I do. You want me to be smart? Just a little more relaxed.
You want me to be Satan, huh?
You want me to take on a fucking skinhead? You
look back and you come right here. I'll take care of
you. You want to hear how my doctor is going to do it, huh? How he's going to
take my body
and sculpt it into this beautiful paper tree? He's going to mold those flesh grafts just right. Just like he molded those lip paint. Curly. Just like me. Oh, good.
Through each other, be like this embodied energy. You ever done crystal before?
Just
like me. You want to get a drink, mellow out, you know, because I want to be your art.
You know, you say that a lot. You know.
I want to be your art.
When was I your art? When you dance for me every time.
I am dancing for me, you know.
No, I don't know.
I'm just out there making
ready. No, that's something your father would say. That's
you don't even know my dad.
I know you, so I know him. That is all you are. You're just personality.
You are saying fucking every
one of them. That's something your brother would say.
Hey, back off, bitch.
That's right. That's somebody,
man, I don't know what the fuck you
want. What the fuck do I want from you?
Man's got his woman to take his seat. He's got the power to pull. She's got the lead.
I dreamt this. Mm-hmm.
I wonder where to go.
know why we broke up, you know? It's just one of those things where neither one of us was in control of the situation, you know? We just went with it.
Your artwork is a mirror.
You've been doing crystal all night.
A reflection of your soul.
It's about 6 in the morning.
Did you ever look in?
You're sitting in the kitchen.
See what you're doing with your life?
I was in that hazy come-down state, you know? Where everything looks like watercolors and then smeared to one side.
I'm sorry, I don't mean to be a dick about it.
I was confused.
I just want to help you get a direction. Is that it?
What?
What do you want?
I don't know. I didn't, you know? I mean, I knew I loved him, but I didn't feel it.
So.
I'm scared. I don't want to fall into that bullshit boyfriend, girlfriend roles, you know, where all of our actions and our thoughts are just reactions to each other's, you know, no separate thing of my own. Yeah, I don't want to be anyone's fucking shadow, okay? I want to find my own way.
I think drugs have fucked up our relationship a little bit.
That's not what I'm talking.
Where are you talking from?
I just want to be alone for a little while, okay?
Maybe I shouldn't come by anymore?
Maybe.
My doctor's gonna do it.
Don't have to do this alone. Don't have to do this alone. Don't have to do this alone. Don't
have to do this alone. Don't have to do this alone. How does God not talk into a beautiful piece of paper? No, it's just like you're in the paper. You can relate to that, right? You're androgynous, just like me. I bet if we tried sincerely, we could pass through each other like disembodied entities.
Bones! What the fuck?
I never slept.
Rob is waiting for you up at first.
I'm sorry.
Oh man, you are fucking up.
It's a problem.
What the hell happened?
2 a.m. and 8 in the sun.
Oh God, Dustin, I am glad you're home.
I wish I knew. I'm
gonna make this quick, you know, before it all starts again.
Has it been around the last few days?
She hasn't even called it. Oh, it just happened from San Jose.
Won't you keep in touch with your roommate?
I had to go on this run for bread.
Hey, that's not. Won't you keep in touch with your daughter?
Man, I am telling you, I'm wild and crazy.
What the hell do you think I am doing?
Weird shit went down.
Give me love on your own terms.
I was like,
drive to this place.
It's all out of our control.
Some gay mafia guy, you know?
Just supposed to do a deal and that'd be it. But we get to this place, and I start feeling real weird, you know? I had a whole rock feeling in my stomach. And Rob's like, be cool, man. And he goes into the dining room with this guy. And this guy, Justin, he was like a sweaty Alfred Hitchcock, you know? Only younger, like about 25. And he starts stroking Rob's hair. And I flash to this dream that Mom had, you know, my eyes, man, they start darting around really wild, you know, it was psychosomatic or something. And then Rob comes out and says that we're gonna spend the night, you know, because it's too late to go back to SF. And I'm thinking, fuck, man. This is a deja vu, you know, and I can't get out of it. So I go to the car, get my bag. And as I am walking back to this place, everything gets this hazy, reddish look to it. I am walking through thick, transparent blood. And I get back inside, and this guy shows me to my room, you know? I mean, it was a nice place. I mean, this guy had money, you know? And in my bedroom, were all these pornographic photographs of these little kids and large reptiles, you know? It was really sick, but I kind of liked it, you know? I kind of got excited on the inside, you know? Not sexual, but just like I'd done a big line of crystal or something, you know? So I decided to take out my sketchbook, you know? I was gonna start drawing for a little while, you know, until I start feeling a little bit more normal. And as I started on something abstract, you know, I saw this really mutated figure, you know? And it was this lady with a fist coming out of her vagina, man. It scared me, you know? I thought I ripped it up. And that's when Rob came in, it started all over again, man. This gray stream started coming out of his mouth towards me, and I got up and I swooped to the side, but it kept coming at me, you know? And he was like, "What the fuck is your problem, bitch?" You know, really vicious towards me. And I told him, "I'm getting the fuck out of here, man." I picked up my bag and I ran for that door. And the Hitchcock got in and grabbed me. He was like, "Where do you think you're going, little girl?" And I swear to God, Dustin, his face turned into Lucius, you know? It was like I was on acid, man, you know? I just bumped out of there as fast as I could to bark. And I can't even mellow out now, you know? Because every time I close my eyes, I get these really twisted visions, you know? I mean, it's like beyond sexual, man. It's like moments of my childhood, you know? And people I know now, they start melting together, you know, into this really evil imagery that scares me, you know? I see these really ugly images of Mom and you. And I can't control it, you know? When I close my eyes, I see Lucia, you know? She's just clawing the walls, clawing harder and harder, like she's trying to escape from somewhere, you know? Her fingers are bleeding, and she's wiping the blood all over the walls of my room and all over my walls on Hopkins Street. I want this shit to stop, okay? Right now!
This shit is so weird.
He didn't answer.
I know you can feel it.
I didn't answer to you. This light opened to everything.
I'm not gonna judge you.
A reflection of your soul.
It was a hell of my own creation. For 27 years, I did what everyone else felt was the most important thing. I played good, normal little girl when my teachers wanted me. When I married, I played housewife, dear father, and I played mother, boy, my mother-in-law, father, children. And the divorce.
It was a slap in the face that said, oh, you didn't play it good enough. And that was the point of departure for my center. I'm going to do everything now. Not their way. Any way but theirs. Even the wrong way. And in the mistakes that I made, maybe I find myself a self that no one had a hand in creating. All my life I had given up my power to other people, and now it was time for me to check my power. I didn't know if it existed. Do you remember this? Do you remember the time of human dirty dishes in the kitchen sink? Air trails leading throughout the kitchen to the broken refrigerator. Our dirty clothes. Fast food for dinner. Stale bread for breakfast. The time of mice nesting in Dustin's bare mattress. The air. So thick and musty with decay that it felt like we were breathing in streams. Those dark shadows passing over us, weighing us down. To who's in custody of your kids, to snap me out of it, to claim back my power. Since that time, I've tried to teach you that you also have that power. You can live that charmed existence or you can give it away. That's up to you. That's what Hopkins Street was. It was a one lesson. We came into his life, from his mother and his children, and his partners. A union with a single life lesson. We followed the dream. And we have to use our power to control that balance. There are times that people try to take our power. People close to us. And I tried to do that. I'm sorry. Very sorry. I don't care if you go back to school or not. I don't care if you continue to dance or not. All I need you to know is that I love you very much. And to find your own happiness.
Herself as a guy, you know, and hang out a lot at Carol Doda's and Madame Rem's. She made him her alter ego, and then she created this whole story of how her alter ego is going to have a sex change. This is going to sound weird, you know, but I think she thought that men had more power in life, you know, and she was going to infuse herself with that power by combining her two selves. I mean, that's one way to break the bullshit conditioning we get and have been getting ever since the days those assholes said we were nothing more than Adam's rib, you know? Not even worthy of our own equal creation. No wonder Lucia tried to recreate herself. And you know, maybe the reason she got hooked on me is because I got a lot of confidence when I dance, you know? I mean, I'm doing this whole Alice Cooper thing, so I'm coming off pretty powerful. I mean, it makes sense, you know? When I was on stage, I was the shadow of what she wanted to be. Mom helped me see all this, you know. She, picked me up from the hospital yesterday. Must have been really weird, you know, seeing me lying in that hospital bed. She had a lot of really cool things to say, you know. Things about the three of us being soul partners for a lifetime. I know this is not your problem, but, when I tell you the story right now last night? Last night I dreamt that I was 5 years old again, you know, and I was looking at all those Jiminy Crickets in the back of our house on Hopkins Street. And just like when I was five, that big cricket, you know, instead of coming towards me, pushing the weeds out of his way, and he got right up to my window and stopped. Took off his top hat and spit that lid in. He looked at me and he said, "Go to hell." But I kind of got these tingles all over, you know, I mean, this sort of euphoric feeling. And I looked at him right in his big glossy eyes and I said, "I have already been there and I'm not going back." And then he smiled, this really kind of evil Vincent Price smile, you know. And he said, "Then you better leave this house." And I woke up.
When you wish upon a star, makes no difference who you are. Anything your heart desires will come.
Instead